Before I show you how to work out the Penney Ante game, imagine this. I've got a bag, and in my bag I have two white balls and three black balls. And I take two balls from the bag without replacing them. What is the probability that I pick at least one white ball? Now, one way to write this down is like this. So this is the first ball, this is the second ball. Now notice that the odds are not even. And notice as well, when I pick a ball, the odds change for the second ball. Now if I want to work out the probability of picking at least one white ball, I'm going to need a couple of pieces of notation first. The probability of A is written like this. It's written with a capital P for probability and A in brackets. So this is the probability of A. So for example, the probability of picking a white ball is 2 out of 5, okay? So that's our first piece of notation. Our second piece of notation is the probability of A given B has happened. So that might be the probability that the second ball is white given that the first ball was black. And you write that like this with a vertical line between A and B. So this is the probability of A given B has happened. So that's our second piece of notation. Now we're going to use a rule of probability, and it looks like this. It says the probability of A is the probability of A given B times the probability of B plus the probability of A given not B times the probability of not B. Let me show you what I mean. If I want to find out the probability of at least one white ball, I can write it like this. The probability of at least one white ball, and I've abbreviated here so I could fit it in, is the probability of at least one white ball given that the first ball was white times the probability that the first ball was white plus the probability of at least one white ball given the probability that the first ball was black times the probability that the first ball was black. Okay, let's look at these terms one by one. The probability of at least one white ball given that the first ball was white, well, if the first ball is white, we have at least one white ball. That the probability is 1, it's certain. Times the probability of the first ball is white, well, that was 2 out of 5. Plus, the probability of at least one white ball given that the first ball was black, well, if you look at the diagram, that was 2 out of 4. Times by the probability that the first ball was black, well, that was 3 out of 5. And all that was on the diagram. Multiply those numbers, add them up, and you get the final answer, 7 out of 10. So that's one way to work out probabilities. And this is what we're going to use to work out the Penney Ante game. Let's say player one picks heads, tails, heads, and player two picks heads, heads, tails. Then the probability that player two wins, we're going to use that rule of probability again, and we're going to go through the four scenarios. So it is the probability that player two wins, you can see I've abbreviated it again there, given the previous two coins were heads, heads, times the probability of heads, heads, plus the probability that player two wins, given the previous two coins was heads, tails, times the probability of heads, tails, plus the probability that player two wins, given the previous two coins was tails heads times the probability of tails heads plus the probability that player two wins given the previous two coins was tails tails times the probability of tails tails. Those are the four scenarios. Now the probability of heads heads, heads tails, tails heads and tails tails are easy to fill in. They're a quarter, so you can fill those in straight away, and we need to work out the other terms like this one. So let's work out this first one, the probability that player two wins given heads heads. To work this out, we're going to use that rule of probability again. So this is the second time we've used it. So it looks like this. There are two scenarios to consider this time. So the probability is the probability that player two wins given heads 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 turns up times the probability of heads plus the probability that player two wins given heads, heads, tails turns up times the probability of tails. So those are our two scenarios. We can start to fill in numbers now. Probability of tails is 1/2, that's easy. the probability that player 2 wins, given heads, heads, tails turns up, well, that's 1. That's certain, because that's what we want. Player 2 picked heads, heads, tails. If heads, heads, tails turns up, player 2 has won. Probability that player 2 wins is certain. It's a 1. Brilliant. We can fill that in. The probability of heads, again, it's another easy one. That's 1/2. And finally, if heads, heads, heads turns up, we're back to square one. You see, the coin has no memory. So if heads, heads, heads turns up, we're really back to where we started, which is the probability that player two wins, given heads, heads, which is the same as this thing over here. So we're back to square one. That's because there's no memory in this game. Great. Now, you can do this idea 3 more times, and this is what you'll get, as you can see. From that, we can start to work out the final things we're missing. Now, if I use equation 1 here, you can rearrange that, and you will find that the probability that player 2 wins, given heads heads, is equal to 1. That came from the first equation. Go through the same sort of idea, use the other 3 equations, and you can work out the other values. So we're missing a few more values. We can work it out using this. Stick them into the equation. We've got everything we need. We've got all the ingredients now. We've worked it all out. Stick them all in, and you get the final answer of 2/3. The probability that player 2 wins is 2/3. If player 1 picks heads, tails, heads, player 2 has 8 choices. You can work out what happens in each case. So it might look like this. This is player 1 here, this is player 2, and player 1 has picked heads, tails, heads. And you can work out the probability that player 2 wins in each case. And you can see from this that the best choice for player 2 is heads, heads, tails. This gives him the best probability. Now, you can fill in the other columns in the same way to find out the best choice each time. If you do, it'll look like this. And I've highlighted in red the best choice for player 2. Now, this is really what I showed you right at the beginning. If I just pick out the red values, it looks like this. And this tells us the best choice for player 2 so that he optimizes his chances of winning. Now, if the two players were to pick independently, this would be a fair game. But if player 1 goes first, player 2 can always increase his chances of winning. It's a great game. If you didn't understand the maths, at least you could try it at home. Do try it on your friends. I would love you to do that. And as usual, if you have been, thanks for watching.